In this video, I will introduce you to some of the AOSP commands which are pretty useful when you work with the terminal window. So here are some of the common AOSP commands. So the first one here is the get top command. So this basically prints the top AOSP directory. Let's quickly try this in the terminal window. I am now in the device common folder. Type get top, prints the top AOSP 12 folder, right? From this particular path, so I am now in device command, right? If I need to go directly to another folder, go to framework base. Okay, so I could simply use cd get top. So the get top will print you the top folder path like mount linux AOSP 12. And from there, you put a slash and framework base. So if you execute this command, then check the path, then you are already in the framework base. So this is a typical use case where you could make use of this get top command. So simply typing get top will print you top AOSP 12 folder. So similarly, if you want to go back to the device command, then what you could do is just give here device slash command. You are already in the device command folder. So now let's look at the croot command, change root. So you can change the folder directory to the root AOSP folder. So let's see this in action. Okay, just let's clear this off. So if you simply type, just check the path. So currently you are in device command. You simply type croot, then you will be back in the AOSP 12 folder. So wherever you are, from there you simply type croot, change root. So then it will change directory to the root AOSP 12 folder. So maybe another quick example, like just go inside build blueprint maybe. From here, so now you are in AOSP 12 build blueprint, and from here if you just simply type croot, you'll be back in the AOSP 12 folder. So the next command is mm. So mm will basically build the package. It will build the package within the current folder. Now I am in the AOSP 12 folder. Okay, so from here I would like to go to one of package. So I have selected packages apps dialer package. So here this is now an app. From this app, I'll quickly modify or just open, change the timestamp of Android manifest.xml. Okay. Let's save it. So from here, if I simply type mm, then it will build only the dialer app. So you could see here, it's actually building only the dialer intermediate classes. Okay, so it's generating the texts. Classes.txt files. Okay, so it's generating the APK. Okay, so it's done. So then you can see that it's actually generated here. The dialer.apk is here. And if you want to directly install this APK, you could simply copy this and ADB. Let's see if there is any devices available. Yeah, install, paste that path. So it'll install to the emulator. Okay, then we have the grep commands. So we have cgrep, jgrep, and resgrep. So cgrep is only for matching C++ files. Jgrep is only for Java source files. And resgrep is only for the resource files. So let's try the cgrep first. Cgrep, let's search for network. So here you can see it's searching all the C++ files. So these are the header files and it's showing wherever the network keyword is used. Okay, similarly, let's try the jgrep. Jgrep, let's search for network again. So these are all Java files as you can see here. And now let's try resource, resgrep. Network, let's see. Yeah, here you go. So there are places where network exists. So it is only showing the XML files, as you can see here. See? Okay, so cgrep, jgrep, and resgrep. So these are also pretty convenient if you want to search from terminal window. Okay, then another one is the go directory. Okay, so this command will help you to go to a particular directory where one particular file exists. So go directory. Let's go to the system server folder. So then I need to search for systemserver.java. Okay, it's not found. Sorry, I think I need to add here now. Okay, so now it was successful. And if you check, you are already inside the folder where the systemserver.java exists. And from here, if you want to jump to the system UI, UI.java, then you are already in system UI.